Hi, it's Kerry. This video is for viewers age 13 plus. Orangutan. With the Borneo orangutans, there are two different forms of mature males. These two types of males are either flanged or unflanged. Flanging happens at around 15 years of age. Dominant flanged males often have an established territory that will encompass multiple females' territories. Multiple females within the male's territory will copulate with him and produce his offspring. The flanged males call to help receptive females locate him. Females much prefer to mate with flanged males, as the unflanged males will force copulation. So the flanged male is a way to ensure protection from unflanged males. Copulation generally occurs with both parties hanging with their arms and facing each other. Borneo orangutans are heavier and thicker and have darker red coats than the Sumatran orangutans. Please subscribe and turn on notifications. The beautiful blue-eared kingfisher, Komodo dragon. They have large serrated teeth that they use to grip prey and rip open its flesh. They have venom glands located between their teeth. The venom these creatures inject into their prey with every deep bite contains toxins that result in anticoagulation and causes low blood pressure and the inability to stop bleeding. Adult Komodo dragons will often cannibalize the juveniles. To avoid predation, they become arboreal. At 8 months, they grow too large to stay up in the trees and alter their diet and become terrestrial. Komodos are even able to take down large deer and water buffalo. 75% of prey dies in 30 minutes. Larger animals may take up to 3 or 4 hours to bleed out. Their strong, powerful neck and razor-sharp teeth are ideal for a slashing attack on prey. They can run quickly up to 20 kilometers per hour and hunt stealthily and powerfully, smashing their prey to the ground and tearing it apart with its claws and teeth. Komodo dragons can only run straight ahead. If you run in a zigzag pattern, then the dragon will give up chase. If you see a traditional wooden stilted house with stairs, climb up those stairs. Javan leopard. I'm going to include the Javan leopard in another video. Sumatran elephant. While differing from the other two subspecies morphologically, anatomically and genetically by having brighter skin with less deep pigmented spots. Males of Sumatran elephants generally exhibit visible tusks which don't grow too long. The tusks of the female elephants are called tushes and they are extremely short and hidden beneath the upper lip. Birth happens at night and lasts approximately 10 seconds. The infant is able to stand up on its own after just 10 to 30 minutes. Borneo elephant is the smallest Asian elephant subspecies. They have long tails that sometimes brush the ground and relatively large ears, rounded bellies and straighter tusks. With mating, there's always a courtship, and the elephants rub trunks together. Their preferred habitat is lowland rainforests and valleys in the northeast region of Kalimantan. Heron bird. This one's actually from Bali. Javan rhino It has a similar mosaic, armor-like skin, much the same as the Indian rhino, although slightly smaller. Measuring up to 4 meters in length and up to 1.7 meters in height. Tail is 70 centimeters and they weigh up to 2,300 kilograms. Adult male horns grow to 25 centimeters. Sumatran rhino. They have 2 horns on their snout, although the frontal horn is much more conspicuous than the nasal horn. It is the smallest of the 5 living species of rhinos. Messiah bird from Sumatra. Please stay and watch another video with me. I love to read and reply to your comments. Thank you for watching my video. See you again soon. See you guys in my next video.